So I also want to touch on what the rescue plan means to public transit. The rescue plan has more than $30 billion in funding for public transit agencies, helping them to avoid layoffs and service cuts. We know that the cuts that these agencies were facing disproportionately harm workers who depend on public transportation, including so many of the workers we have belatedly come to call essential workers. So this is a matter of equity. It was a matter of doing right by so many of the heroes of the pandemic. In the Washington metropolitan area alone, $1.4 billion has been set aside under the American Rescue Plan to provide economic relief to transit operators in the D.C. area, Maryland suburbs, and Northern Virginia, including WMATA and other transit operators. The project we're celebrating today will help people across the region, and the work we're doing collectively will help people across the country. So we're going to continue to look to see success stories like this in communities large and small across the country if we seize the moment that's upon us, a once-in-a-century alignment of demonstrated need, bipartisan interest, public impatience, and I can tell you, a very supportive president leading the way. And we can't wait to work with our partners in states and communities, and of course in the Senate and the United States Congress, to get this done.
Today we're celebrating a major, major milestone in our work to make it easier for people and goods to move around Virginia and up and down our East Coast. Together with our partners at Amtrak, CSX, and VRE, we are finalizing the agreements needed to move forward with a tremendous project, our $3.7 billion Transforming Rail in Virginia initiative. This transformative plan will make travel faster and safer. It will make it easier to move up and down our East Coast, and it will connect urban and rural Virginia. Under this new initiative, the Commonwealth will construct a new bridge over the Potomac dedicated to passenger rail, acquire 386 miles of rail right-of-way and 223 miles of track, and invest more than $1 billion in additional rail infrastructure projects over the next decade. This project establishes a pathway to separate passenger and freight operations, which will help both run more smoothly and efficiently.